this kitchen.
It's always a mess. So I thought I'd share one more little quick, easy Halloween craft that I did with Nola this year. And it is quite simply our spider soap. So we had some googly eyes and some little sticky glittery spiders, and we just peeled the label off of our soap and stuck them on. We glued on the googly eyes. You could also make this look a little fancier if you had some like Halloween colored ribbon to stick along the top. I've seen some other really cool Halloween crafts with soap that also look very easy. I didn't want to have to go out and buy any more supplies to make these little crafts. We just wanted to make do with what we had, so that was what we made. This really cool little paper plate spider web that we made. Very, very easy to do. It's, you need paper plates, yarn, no matter what color you have. I just happen to have black plates and some white yarn. And you know, it's a great little lacing activity. It's something that my daughter went back to a few times. You just punch some holes in the rim of a paper plate, even if you don't have a pole puncher. A hole puncher. Use scissors, use a screwdriver, whatever you've got, make some holes in the side. I will say I did put some glue on the tip of the yarn so that it would smoothly go through the hole and not just fray on the ends. And I had to help her a little bit to lace it across the black part of the plate instead of the back of the plate. And I did this in about 4 or 5 strands so that the yarn strands wouldn't be too long, because they just get tangled if they're too long. And you just lace back and forth until all of the holes are filled, basically, is what I told her. And we stuck those little glittery spiders on, and she loves it. She does have a slight obsession with spiders and spider webs, so this was a great craft that really targeted her interest. Other than that, we didn't do too much. We did the leaves in wax paper. She's really been playing with the gourds a lot that we had out. She collects them every day and moves them around the living room in her kitchen and pretend she's going to the pumpkin patch or to the grocery store, and really loves those kind of things. And now with Halloween is just a few days away, and I think what we're going to do this year is we're just gonna play Halloween inside. Last year we went to a few of our neighbors' houses. She kind of remembers because it's the first time she has been outside at night other than just traveling to or from a car. It was raining. So, you know, she really does remember last year, which, you know, doesn't really amaze me because she remembers absolutely everything, this child. But this year, in light of the state of the world right now, I don't think we're gonna go out trick-or-treating. I think we're just gonna play trick-or-treat in the house. I mean, we have enough doors. We have this closet door right here. We have our bathroom door on the main floor, along with our front door, our back door, and then upstairs, you know, there's bedrooms, there's bathrooms, there's closet. So I think between my husband and I, we're just gonna take turns getting behind these doors, and she can knock on the doors and do her trick-or-treating within the house with her mom and dad and little brother. I think that's gonna be the plan. So we'll definitely make a video about how our trick-or-treating goes. If you like this video about our super easy, toddler-friendly Halloween crafts, then please give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Thanks.